It's important to recognize that the session here in Bonn over the next 2 weeks really represents a significant new step in the talks. Governments have on the table for the first time real negotiating texts which can serve as the basis to start drafting an agreed outcome in Copenhagen. And it's important that to point out that the negotiating texts at this point do not prejudge or preclude any particular outcome. That Copenhagen will deliver, I have no doubt that it will. The question then is, what actually constitutes a successful outcome in Copenhagen? And I've mentioned before that there are, in my mind, four political essentials on which Copenhagen has to deliver. The first is absolute clarity on by how much industrialized countries will reduce their emissions by 2020. And there we have already an almost full list of industrialized nations' pledges by how much they intend to cut their emissions. The second essential point is clarity on what major developing countries will do to limit the growth of their emissions. And their signs are also encouraging. Developing countries are not waiting and doing nothing, but have indicated a willingness to move beyond what they're doing already, providing international financial support is provided. The third, and I referred to it just now, is clarity on stable and predictable finance for both adaptation and mitigation. We need clear and significant public funding commitments from industrialized countries and to see how public sector resources can mobilize resources from the private sector as well. Fourth and finally, clarity on governance. What will be the new governance regime under a Copenhagen agreed outcome? And this is especially important in the areas of finance and technology, where developing countries have made it very clear they want bodies constituted on which they are adequately represented to look after their own interests. Clearly, there are some hard nuts still to crack. But having said that, I think there is also some softer fruit that we can pick at this particular session. Either way, under both the convention and the protocol, important negotiating texts are on the table, and how they are discussed will help us to move forward. And at the same time, there is important ongoing work to be undertaken under the two subsidiary bodies of the convention, including a very important debate on the review of the financial mechanism and a very important discussion on capacity building, to mention just two items that have a close relationship with the broader negotiations towards Copenhagen. Thank you.